Latinx women.
Yes.
And set the tone and stage for queer and trans liberation.
Yeah.
Black Lives Matter, the global network, grew from a phrase to a hashtag to an online community to a vibrant global movement with 40 chapters here in the US and Canada and the United Kingdom.
Woo-hoo!
But we are here in DC, where a vibrant Black Lives Matter chapter has been alive and well since 2014. BLMDC has, with their partners, set off citywide opposition to an organizing campaign that led to the defeat of Mayor Bowser's draconian crime bill that would have increased criminal penalties and incarceration and would have supported warrantless searches. They've helped recenter Black people in DC's organizing spaces, shifted the organizing perspective and attitude around the city that organizing must be led by Black folks if DC wants to be effective. They have set the tone for resisting Trump in ways that centered Black people. This included the centering of those, the long history of police brutality and the criminalization of dissent for Black people and our collective solidarity with the J20 Inauguration Day defendants. They participated in network-wide Black response for Standing Rock, for floods in Baton Rouge, for the flat water crisis and floods in Houston, push advocacy work in the city to be more accountable to Black community. They have a historic lawsuit, Black Lives Matter DC versus Bowser. I start with this chapter's successes and victories because the local work changes and shifts the national work. Every shutdown, every sit-in, every meeting and challenge towards racist, white supremacist, homophobic, and transphobic policies happens at the local level and impacts and changes the national and global context. The work we have to do right now for each other and for Black people is even more necessary and urgent. I want to lift up the heroes who lost their children, friends, partners, husbands, wives, cousins, nieces, aunties, uncles, loved ones, to a vicious state that eats our people alive and then gives us no room for hope or justice. Jay Brown, uncle of Jeff Price, chased by MPD and killed May 4th, 2018. Ms. Marion Gray Hopkins, co-founder and director of the Coalition of Concerned Mothers, whose 19-year-old son, Gary, was shot to death by a Prince George County police officer in 1999. Ms. Cynthia DeShola Dawkins, co-founder and board chair of Coalition of Concerned Mothers, whose son Timothy, who lost his life in the crossfire shooting in Southeast Washington, D.C. on August 21st, 2013. Ms. Burnett McFadden, community advocate, Coalition of Concerned Mothers, sons that were murdered 6 weeks apart. My three sons are Reginald, Randolph, and Lynn McFadden. The first son, Reginald McFadden, was murdered February 8, 2005, 7 days after his 18th birthday. Reginald was a comedian. He always made them laugh. I also want to lift up the millions of people who have survived incarceration, torture, and isolation. I want to lift up the survivors of state violence, those of you who have been able to tell your stories, allowing us not to make you a hashtag. This moment and honor is for Black people around the globe fighting tooth and nail for our collective freedom. And as our mama Asada Shakur says, it is our duty to fight for our freedom. It is our duty to win.
It is our duty to win.
We must love each other and support each other.
We must love each other and support each other.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to